this song. This sets it up. When we're talking family, Ramona King, she is here, a real estate expert from Money Sense, senior editor as well. You have done some homework on this.
Yes, we've really been looking at the market. It's interesting, right? Things change quickly. There's micro trends on top of trends on top of national trends. And so Vancouver has definitely changed its tune. I mean, for the last decade, it's been so hard to get a single family to detach. It's been so hard to get into the market. And now all of a sudden, within a short period of time, let's say 6 to 9 months, suddenly single family detached, it's possible again.
Yeah.
Right?
Quickly, before we get into the list and the research that you found, all of these bumps in the interest rate, what have you found of seeing a 1% bump up in interest rate? What does that do to purchasing power?
Well, this is the thing, is that people are realizing after the last two interest rate hikes by the Bank of Canada, hey, I'm losing purchasing power. And so we did a quick calculation and realized for every 100 basis points, so that's 1% increase in the interest rate, you lose 10% of your purchasing power. So
wow.
If you're buying in Vancouver or Toronto where it's like $1 million home, that's a lot.
Big, big impact. Okay, so I want to get through as much as possible. In Metro Vancouver, the best neighborhoods to look for single-family homes, maybe one or two examples that you saw.
Marpole, Hastings East, and on the east side, Collingwood. There's a bit of a caveat here. We look at numbers. It's hard to quantify neighborhoods. We do, when it comes to community, we do look at walk scores and transit scores to try and replicate that. These neighborhoods have great walking scores, which means you can walk to amenities, you can walk to restaurants. Are they the trendy restaurants you want yet? No, not necessarily. But they're great neighborhoods that are just on the cusp of gentrification. So what does that mean? If you get in now when prices for single-family homes are dropping, these neighborhoods are starting to have massive buildup of single-family homes. Let's say even half these sellers are serious. That means they're going to have to adjust their prices so you can get in at an even lower than list price. And then if you wait 5 to 10 years, you're going to be sitting in a really hip neighborhood paying very little.
Playing the long game on this. What about for condos in Greater Vancouver?
For condos in Greater Vancouver, we looked at different areas. And a lot of the areas that we saw, sort of the gentrification. You're going to have to remind me, sorry.
Yes. South Cambie was on the list.
South Cambie,
Shaughnessy,
yes.
East side neighborhood of Renfrew as well.
Yeah, so South Cambie, one of the great things about South Cambie is it's already got a community. It's right by that the Hillcrest Aquatic Center. I know people from North Vancouver that drive down to that Hillcrest.
Beautiful venue.
Great venue, and it's right beside that massive park. So it's a great little area that you can walk in and have a community already in there. And we're already seeing condos. There's a buildup of the condos. Again, when you've got a buildup of inventory, what happens? You get people that are motivated sellers. They're going to accept lower than list price, and that's good for buyers right now.
And if we take it out further out, Greater Vancouver, single family homes, Richmond, Coquitlam, another one in Richmond, what, Lackner and Richmond too? What do
Lackner
you
and Saunders, yes. We think that there's a big run up on Richmond. There was a lot of, we're going to say it, there might have been a lot of potential foreign buyers that wanted to buy in Richmond. They ran up the prices of condos and townhomes. What's happened? Well, we've had extra taxes that have come in for vacated homes, for foreign buyers, for different reasons. And so there's not as much interest. And so now sellers who might want to try and capitalize on some of their gains, or people that just are overstretched, they're putting them on the market. We're seeing a buildup of inventory. Lackner and Saunders. Saunders in particular for both condos and houses. And that signals to me this is an overpriced area. Sellers are going to have to adjust their expectations of what they're going to sell for, which means buyers can probably come in. And for us, we really try and emphasize this. It's a numbers game at this point. If you really love a home, go in hard and then wait. See if it moves. And the seller might be motivated the next time if it sits on the market for 30, 40, 50 days. They might accept a lower offer then.
And then final thoughts, condos, townhomes in places like Queensborough or Central Burnaby?
Central Burnaby is a great place. I mean, it's a really built-up area, and it's not a surprising thing. It's nestled in between two channels of water. So if you go there, it's actually got a great sort of waterfront community feel. And New Westminster, we know that's so close to downtown Vancouver. It's a great commuter spot. So now you've got, you know, homes and condos in these areas that are actually quite accessible. It's a bit of a drive when you get to New Westminster, and transit's a little difficult, but if you don't mind the hour commute by transit, maybe read a book or catch up on your daily news.
Podcast,
yes, yeah. Absolutely. I'm a big fan of podcasts. Then it's a great little spot because you're getting in at a good price. You still get good commuter distance.
Where do we find all this research online? Because there were so many, and only so many we're going to go through here.
Well, I mean, Zolo.ca is a great place, but I also say Van City Condos. These are two areas, two different resources where we track the metrics, we track the data, and we try and contextualize the data so that you're making good, smart money decisions for a really large investment.
Well, thanks for doing the homework. only a few that we went through, but definitely check out the sites. Romana, thanks again. We'll take a break.